Hey everybody, today is July 11th, 2011. This is the Fallout Show, filmed on location here in beautiful, sunny Ypsilanti, Michigan. Thank you again for joining us, everybody. For our first wonderful story of the day, we have Facebook Music Service. Some code was released, or discovered over the weekend, that Facebook might possibly be launching a music service. Now, there's a lot of, it's a lot of rumor. The code looks like this. We're going to put right here. Are you putting it there? Okay, good. There's rumors that Facebook's going to be actually partnering with Spotify, which we did on a story on last week, so you guys are kind of familiar with that. If you're not, Spotify is a music streaming service, kind of like Rhapsody or Napster, and it's going to be launching here in the U.S. soon, so there's a lot of rumors that it's coming out, you know, with that. Right now, it's per code labeled Facebook Vibes, all rumor, speculation, but with Facebook kind of grasping... they're definitely shaking a little bit from Google Plus, which, by the way, I finally got my damn invite. Thank you, Tom. And it is phenomenal. I love this service. Circles is by far the coolest thing I think I've ever seen on a social network. I can pick and choose who my messages go to and that kind of thing. It's awesome. But anyways, so Facebook might be launching this music service. They're really starting to grasp for anything to keep people interested. We've got, you know, stuff for pictures, video chat, which they kind of botched a little bit, and music. So I guess I got to keep our eye on Facebook, see what they're going to be doing over the next couple weeks here. But I don't know. See what happens. So pretty interesting story for Apple fans this week. Kyle MacDonald is a New York City artist who went into over 100 different Apple stores and installed software on all of the Apple computers that would take pictures from the Apple Cam every minute and send them to his personal server. Now, when he walked in, he asked the guards, can I take pictures inside this store? All of them said yes, so not an issue, right? No, there's an issue. The Secret Service visited Kyle this week, raided his house, took his laptop, iPhone, all of his other devices, and there's a big case against him right now, but we're going to throw a couple of these pictures up, courtesy of the International Business Times, and, I mean, look at these. This really showcases what people look like when they use their computers. I mean, absolutely blank stares, emotionless, just zombies, and kind of showcases, you know, what technology's turning us into. But, hey, I don't necessarily see this as art, but I think it's kind of cool. So good luck to you, Kyle. Hopefully you keep yourself out of jail. All right, guys, now we've done a couple stories in the past about different innovative charging methods. We did, you know, the story about the Japanese, you know, cooking pot that charged your iPhone. Seth last week did an awesome story for us on a device that uses kinetic energy to charge your stuff. This week, we have another one for you. This one really caught my eye. It's from a company called Element 5. It is a solar iPad bag. Okay, so it's a shoulder bag, looks like any everyday typical messenger bag, Swiss made, so obviously we know it's going to be really good quality, with a solar cell on the outside that charges your iPad. I really like how innovative people are being with charging. I mean, it's always frustrating when you're on the go and you pull out your device and, oh, I've got 20% battery. Oh, that's awesome. Yay. Now, if you're in one of those, especially if you're in one of those sunnier states, California, Texas, all you lucky people out there, you can charge your device while walking around town. Really kind of cool. We're gonna link to Element 5's site because they have a lot of really cool solar stuff and innovative ways of charging different devices, not just iPads. They have some, you know, the Explorer bag, which is, you know, more for you know, just outdoors in general. I really like their stuff. I think it's awesome. A bit on the pricey end at $412, but hey, you're being green and it's Swiss made, so you know you're gonna pay for the quality of it. But hop over to Element 5, check out their stuff. They got some amazing, amazing things. All right, guys, for our last story of the day, well, I really shouldn't call it a story. Our last piece of the day, I want to tell you first off that I love to eat. Subsequently, what? What'd you just say? Fat ass? Really?
Yep.
Thanks. Thanks for narrowing to my story to call me a fat ass.
Yep.
Seriously. Fucking. Anyways. So, subsequently, I love to cook. Goji is a new website that I stumbled across today that is every cook's dream. You can do a lot with this website. The first option is obviously you can tell it what you're craving. You know, whether it's bologna to, I don't know, sauerkraut. And it will give you recipes based on those things. You can also tell it the ingredients that you have. And it'll come up with recipes for that. And you can also tell it what you dislike or what you're allergic to, that kind of thing. And it'll keep you far away from that stuff. While it's doing this, it pulls up big, beautiful pictures of the recipes that just make your mouth absolutely water. So this is my new favorite website. I've been spending crap tons of time on this website, probably more than I should looking at food because all it's done all day is make me hungry. And that's obviously what I need right now is more food to eat. So anyways, guys, hop over to goji.com, check it out. It is an awesome site. You'll have a lot of fun, especially if you like to cook. Thank you everybody for joining us. That is all the fallout I have for you this Monday. Hop on over to Facebook, follow us there, follow us on Twitter, subscribe to this channel, like the video, and hop over to connected.com and sign up for our newsletter. Eventually, we're actually going to write one again.
Bow, bow.